proclaim the good news of Jesus, O Lord. We extend a special welcome to Bishop Peter Fenty, or Peter. We welcome him back home at a time when we are a bit warmer than his adopted home, Canada. Bishop Peter was among that group of students who made a culture in the early 1970s. It was an era when Cotterton was searching for some evacuated model of Christian ministry. Those of us who were students at that time were privileged to be part of this process on the guidance of relationship theology. After working this diocese in several parishes, Christ, the Kings, Patrick, and St. Louis, Bishop Fenty migrated to Canada and continued in ministry there, first in Montreal and then in Toronto. He later became an archdeacon in the Diocese of Toronto, and in 2013 was elected an early bishop of York Simcoe in the Diocese of Toronto. It was with great joy that his election was accepted here in Barbados. Many Barbadians were privileged to attend his consecration in Toronto. We are all proud of your team. We wish you God with blessings in your ministry. We eagerly look forward to your word to us. We have no doubt that we will be given much food for thought this morning. Welcome, Mr. Peter.
Living in Canada, but in particular in Toronto. wake up and decide to come home. Or come. So I suspect they're going to remain put. On the window there, I mean the grove. I also bring good wishes and prayers from Canons Anthony John and Stephen Fields, and their good wishes for your ministry. My wife Angela regrets not being able to be with me because of teaching commitments, but joins me in offering my family's gratitude and sincere appreciation of the prayers, emails, cards, telephone calls, and support given to us on the occasion of my ordination and consecration as a bishop of the church. I was particularly happy that the Archbishop was there to be the preacher, and to the clergy and lady who came and was there for us. We are most appreciative. It is also for me a joy to be back home. Visiting with my aged father, my sister and four brothers, other family members and friends. I deliberately did not check the weather forecast in Toronto this morning because I didn't want to feel guilty about being here and there managing the cold and the snow. Then the Archbishop called and asked if I would come and meet with you. This was quite a number of months ago. And I first told my family they were not impressed. And then when I made it known to the clergy, I had so many offers of chaplains to join me. So I did the wise thing. I came alone. But it is indeed a joy to be with you and to be here present and celebrating on this wonderful day in the life of your diocese. I pray God's blessing upon your ministry and upon what God is inviting and calling each of you to do in God's name, witnessing the gospel. May the words of my lips, the meditation of all our hearts, be known always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, O strength and our Redeemer. Brothers and sisters, God is an awesome God.
Yes.
A God who is gracious and whose mercies endure forever. A God who created us in God's own image and likeness, and invites us every day to live as co-creators with Him in building the kingdom. The kingdom prepared for us in Christ Jesus, the kingdom that He will come Himself to continue to establish on that day when He will gather us all up. That the good and gracious God we worship, serve, and adore, but may enable us in that mission, that others may know the love of God, and that we as a church will go forward in confidence to tackle the challenges, to support one another, and friends, to make a great difference in the lives of those who live on this beautiful island. I leave with you some very familiar words from one of our wonderful leaders. The last two verses of him 604. And I leave this in the context that sometimes we can despair and despondent and not sure if we have the capacity to do what we know God probably is asking of us. But if we believe that God is with us, if we believe that God is very present in our daily lives, and that God is working his purpose out, then, in faith and in confidence of this good, loving, and gracious God, we can remind ourselves of the words in this hymn. And we, Shall we be faithless? Shall hearts fail, hands and none? Shall we evade the conflict and cast away our crown? Not so. In God's deep counsels, some better thing is sure. We will maintain unflinching one church, one faith, one Lord. Thy mercy will not fail us, nor leave thy work undone. With thy right hand to help us, the victory shall be won. And then by men and angels, thy name shall be adored. This shall be their anthem, one church, one faith, one Lord. God bless you. Amen.